friends. I'm kind of stunned with what I've got to report today. But let me have a go at reporting it. It's really quite stunning. Okay? Let's see if you can guess what we're going to profile. Okay, it's George Lees in his friend's living room, and thanks ever so much to his friend for allowing him to make these videos in the conditions that we currently have here. The weather has been quite bizarre, and all of that is created by the news that the gods have been completely replaced, by everything. Ken Dodd died this week, and that is the Diddy Man. That will be explained in the video today. Okay, but we'll start with the religious scholar that is this man. Okay, and the woman that is the birth of Christmas, and who may be running for president very soon. Cannot tell you her name at the moment, but there is the man that quite stunningly I now believe is descended from Arius Calpurnius Piso directly through the bloodline. And this is the picture. The gods told me before I got up this morning that I must look for statue of Josephus. And when I did, the image that I saw was that one. And all of it. So let me take you back and show you the other images that we get. Okay, see, he's got a bent and slightly broken nose, as if he's been in trouble, and he's a sectarian religious joker, because his band is called Fold. Okay, I'm going to set that there, and I'm going to click it backwards until you can see the images of Josephus, aka, which is the pen name only for Arius Calpurnius Piso. Stunningly, that man, let me show you. So Coldplay is centuries old play, and there's one of the atmospheric planets circling above the... Oh no, it's not going to let me... Oh yeah. So there's the face that you need to look at. Keep that in your mind and we'll go back. Coldplay, Chris Martin. None of those are in a side profile, but there we've got a side profile for. Okay, there is the profile that stunned me this morning. There it is again, and that is the Roman man that is the most powerful in the world, and that is the picture that you're more used to. When he was older, with the turban on, and it is just stunning. So that is Flavius Josephus's statue in Rome, and all along the top row, it looks just like, I believe, Christopher Martin, and that does not surprise me one bit. Christopher Martin was actually the money man on the Mayflower, and I've told you that again and again and again, okay? So that is Arius Calpurnius Piso, and some of the websites I've discovered for him are absolutely fabulous. Okay, that man there with the turban on is Arius Calpurnius Piso. There he is again. Let me take you up close and remind you what he looks like. And remind you what. Okay. Thank you. just do that on that computer. I don't think we'll get any hum from it. But let's project it on. No, let's just do it here. Okay, so the sound's off. This is Oprah introducing us to Shania Twain, who is, she thinks she's a goddess. Only time will tell. That's the reason she was a goddess, and the reason that her voice failed her for a full decade is that she sings about all the jokes about the Panthera regiments, the Panther jokes for the Pisos, and that is her in her fabulous leopard skin outfits. Okay, so here we go. And what they're singing is the reminder that every false religion takes you back to Joseph and Mary, but not in the garden necessarily, because all of them are the Isis myths, and that is the Isis myths, that you have a Joseph and a Mary, yeah, and this one, this time it becomes betrayed by, in Egypt they are betrayed not by Judas, but by Judah, and that is Charlton Heston's role in the movie, yeah, about the charioteers, and that is God's role, just God's daily motion is to circulate the earth and let it get radiated by the sun, and I'll show you now what God has been replaced by. Okay, where is it? His replacements are, so there is Joseph Flavius, yeah, and the reason that the Krauss woman also sings with Oprah not with Oprah, she Krauss often sings in a threesome with Dolly Parton, which is the joke about the Parthenon in Egypt, and the Greek gods and the Roman gods all being totally replaced by Piso family members, and the first pope was St. Peter. He also is Flavius Josephus, yeah, because his name, he plays the role of St. Peter, he plays the role of Joseph, and because of the Marian insertions, he plays the mother and the father of Arius Copernicus Piso, and that is the mother and father of God, that is Jesus now. That is the biggest and sickest joke in world history. Let me show you what the humans now think of the gods. Okay, here it is. There is the parody on the sun god Sol. Let me take it further up and explain the death of Ken Dodd this week. Yeah, do you get the Dodimos and the Didymos? There is Solus, the 5.41 metres, 17.7 foot tall garden gnome in Nova Sol, that's new sun god Sol Natalis Invictus. Yeah, and they have to go through that all over Dundee, all over the borders. You see the gardens filled with the people that have been the gods in the past in their story. And that gets just as ruthless in Scotland, because there is the god now dead, and there is the garden gnome, a German one, yeah, invented in Germany, these things, okay, and there is the massive pistic that this is. I think we've got further down some Toby jugs. Okay, so there is what has replaced the sun that irradiates our universe. Can you hear them howling outside? You can see the sun, which is the crown of thorns on Jesus' head. Okay? And you can see that all of those prerequisites for having a new god have been written about for thousands, millions and millions of years. And it takes you right back into ancient Egypt, where Shania Twain's husband plays the role of Mut, one of the gods of Egypt. Yeah.
Irish people told me the other week that she's dropped out of that plan now, but this is the only thing they can do to cover things is to demonize. There was a bridge collapsed in America yesterday. So do you get the new Saul in Poland, the tall garden at Nome? Yeah, there's a giant on the beach, and if you look close up at that, it is the little ashes container, and that, for a laugh, in the Fifth Element movie. Yeah, the four elements are air, earth, wind, and fire. Yeah, and that is the parody that the sun god is now just one of the giants that you find on the beach. And they need to be demonized, because what happened in that place, is, it's the Colossus of Rhodes. So that's the foundation of the Rhodes Trust by the world's fascists. And this is a god to replace the gods. Yeah, they're quite brazen about it. And there is the little icon. Got tiny little heads, the gods, and that is the portrayal of them as being simpletons and stammering conversations only with simple humans like George the Sixth are they capable of. Yeah, I know what they're capable of, and when this in Colossus in I think it's North Africa, but it is a Greek colonial place with all their shipping devices, that whole massive statue, there's another one in the picture below, so there is the way in, it's Helios, and that is the god's helicopter, a god to equal the god, one of the seven wonders of the world, and the ancient forerunner of the Statue of Liberty. The Colossus of Rhodes remains an inspiring mystery because, in very early after they had created it, the gods brought it down with an earthquake. And that is the god that really exists in the heavens with all of his friends up there, and they are much more powerful than any human being that ever lived. So that is the launch of the Colosseum for the giants and the tiny little humans that are dancing around. Yeah, and this the statue is absolutely gigantic compared to humans, but not to the gods. Okay, and there is all the police launches, Antagonus, Demetrius, Pollio, Arsetes, and the Pollios are on the Piso family pseudonym listings. Yeah, Bill Gates, you little shit. Yeah, to attack in Rhodes in 305 to 304 BC, and that's the force of the island breaking its ties with Ptolemaic Egypt, and that is the links also to the Pisos through Mark Antony and Cleopatra. Yeah? So Mut is an Egyptian god, and the reason that Shania loses her voice, I believe, is that she plays the role of the goddess Sebel. Yeah, and she dances around in the Panthera uniform, which later in world history becomes, and there's the Helipolis, city destroyed, 40 metres high, 20 metres wide, and that's the naming of the global police after these scamsters. Yeah, it's time to end it now, and I can't see the gods giving them a way out. Unless they conciliate and climb down from the newsmongering scams which become wars in due course. Okay, and let me just show you the fucking pictures and images of everything that they try to do. So there's the entrance to the harbour. There's Greece is. Notice pot of ashes is from the sun god Saul, and that is the death of the sun god Sol in human opinion. Okay, and there is the gigantic structure that was one of the seven wonders of the world. And I forget when exactly the earthquake that destroyed it occurred, but I understand those issues are going on. Yeah. One of the seven wonders of the world. Look at the size of the structure and look at the sun god's wings on his head. Yeah? And the ancient forerunner of the Statue of Liberty, the Colossus of Rhodes, remains an inspiring mystery. Yeah, so I believe that it will be a statue of Emperor Augustine that the gladiators see when they first see the Colosseum. But the Colosseum is named after Colossus of Rhodes. Isn't it interesting? Yeah, and I wish, I don't know where I've got the Toby jugs. It could be on that second one. So this is the Alexander the Great stories that take you right back into Macedonia, and all of that is way before the pharaoh bloodlines were run. Arsenal were on the telly again last night. Yeah, and that's all the humans have to offer, theatrical agent. I cannot see where the Toby jug pictures are. Maybe they're on another. So every round thing in the world, including that held by Lionel Messi, yet of Barcelona, and the covers for all the terror, that is the Ballon d'Or, that is the sun god that circulates our earth. And the human's version of this story now is that they are so powerful, yeah, and they are capable of bigger explosions, they think, than Josephus's statue. So let's have another look. Okay, there's Chris Martin with the broken nose in profile in this one. Okay, I think if we wait for a couple of seconds, we'll see that that is Josephus. Yeah, married to Gwyneth Paltrow and part of that massive religious god. His name, I don't know what it was when his parents actually sired him and delivered him in the birthing chamber, but if he's Chris Mark, it is a massive coincidence. So that's the money man on the Mayflower, descended from the earliest popes and the earliest characters in biblical history. So that is the fucking man that wrote the Bible, and he's a dead ringer for him. I hope you will agree to that. You can look it all up for yourself. And that is him knowing that St. Peter in the Viva La Vida music will not call his name to the pearly gates, because St. Peter is Arius Calpurnius Pisa too. Yeah, I discovered a website on that last week, and all of it now reveals that everybody in the Gordonian lineages. Yeah, that's the Gordonian line that leads to the creation of the school on Speyside for the surviving relatives of the Gordonian. Gordonian popes, all of which are Piso members. I'll try and find that website later on if I can. Okay. Yeah, and the other folk that are in that, everybody in the Gavin and Stacey cast are massive. So James, he's not Corbin, he's James Corden. The Cordons are also a Piso pseudonym, and they were the earliest popes in false Christian history. Yeah, and that was the clever people that changed their names and moved away from Naples, because Vesuvius was intimidating them as a tool for the gods in the acts of God that occurred there. Right then, so what else can I show you? Let's first show you the myths that we need to adhere to if we're going to save our souls. Coldplay. Yeah, there's the Jewish Encyclopedia version of Josephus Flavius. That is T. Flavius Sabinus. And all of the families that are the T. Flavius ones are profiled in this fabulous website that I found this morning. Okay, I've not had time to archive any of it yet. I just need to get the video out before the police arrive at my doorstep. Josephus, End Times Study. Yeah? And this is the Jewish version. He's appointed, guess where he's appointed to be the boss, as a non-existent writer, yeah, for the false news or through history. This is the man that launched Jesus way after he was actually, way before Jesus is supposed to have been born in the year Dot. That is when Emperor Augusta took over in 4 AD. But this one, Joseph Flavius, who lived up to about 100 AD, born in 37 or 38, died after 100. He boasts of belonging to the Hasmonean race and his mother's side. His great-grandfather was Simon the Stammerer. You get it? Yeah? The simpletons who are capable of negotiating with God. Yeah? And it's really fucking dangerous. Okay? And he was appointed first the governor of a place called Galilee. I can't remember where that comes into biblical history. Can you? Okay. And let's just have a look at the other tabs and their contents. So that's the Marcians. Yeah, another lineage in ancient Rome. Okay. Field McConnell. And your sister, Marcia, and all of her bad behaviours to you. Yeah, all of it. And that becomes the threat from outer space. Okay. Marcia, us. Yeah, all of them are absolutely intertwined in the same families. And he was the story at the beginning of the new tale that I've discovered this morning. Is absolutely fabulous. Shania Twain. So there is, this time we need the other computer. There is, yeah, so you get, let's just finish all these tabs and see what they are. Okay, and then I'll take you onto the other computer. The Colossus of Rhodes, a god to equal God. Yeah? Look it up for yourself, look at the images, and there is the icon, yeah, of the little tin men that are the gods. They come down in an ashes shaped pot which he's got in his left arm. Tab later on. Okay, see him. There he is again, all over those cars. We get the giant on the reach now, and it's just like a man. Yet they pretend that they are powerful. That's why King David had to confront the man that was the Goliath. Yeah. And the gods are ever so gusty today. Next time. And I don't know what we've got before that, but that can be quite revealing after what I found this morning. There he is again. Yeah, all the tiny little boats. Do you remember the Jason and the Argonauts? That's Jah's son. I'm fleecing the whole world. Yeah, out of that Aegean Greek region. Okay, and you get the posture of the Statue of Liberty. There is no liberty, there never will be, while the Pisopolis are in charge of the global law enforcement, and the judiciary are even more corrupted and even more on the take. What else? There's the Toby jugs. Okay, that's the same joke as the little dwarfs that you see. Yeah, the little elves in the garden. Yeah, that's the Britney Spears joke. Yeah, for the world new families that understand that everything they pretend to be perturbed about on the news is just a massive mistake. Okay, that's the Toby jugs that were stolen from my Uncle John in Falkirk. Yeah, all of that is too domestic for you to understand, but there are the Toby jugs. And that is the Diggy Man concept for Ken Burke, who died this week. Yeah, that's the replacement with Dionysus and all the godly figureheads with puppets. Sorry, I'm just going to whip through the tabs. No, we can't get that one. Let's just go back. Okay, so this one is the Marcian bloodlines. We've seen that. That's the emperors in Rome. And this is now 25th of August, 450 AD. Yeah, so all of it has turned to false religion now. Marcian was elected and inaugurated on 25th of August, 450. Not sure what we've got before that. I doubt that there's very much. Martian, so the Julio-Claudian dynasty, there's the Flavians, that is Pisa, because all of them are in the first 100 AD. The Flavian dynasty was a Roman imperial dynasty which ruled the Roman Empire between 69 AD and 96 AD, encompassing the reigns of Vespasian, who's vitally important on the top of the family tree that I'm going to tell you about. And it's got all of the massive jokes of Hollywood in all the family members. There's a Jessius, and that is the woman that gets a kick off all the time in those movies that were made by the hopeless bellboy actors. And all of them die really young after they've made the jokes. And that Smithy guy, I don't know how he survived for so long. He's part of all the massive frauds. That's Piggott Smith, Maggie Smith, and everything that takes you right back to Poppea in the Roman's court. So that is the comedy team for the Yellow Barns, yeah, for Maggie Smith. And that is Corbin, that is also in Pisa bloodline. Papal dynasty this time, it's not an emperor. Yeah, but they're all through both of those strands, and all of them are directly descended from Pisa. Right, so, and here's the rules in the Bible for fault. Oh, no, it's not. This is the Jewish religions. There's him being appointed governor of Galilee, yeah, and writing in Syriac, in Hebrew, and in modern languages as well as Greek. Yeah, wins favour of Vespasian, and then the whole of the regime is murderous, and we stab each other in the back. And I'm making the video one day after ever was a real St. Peter or a St. Andrew or a St. Jesus, because all of them are the pen of Piso that wrote the whole story and launched Josephus as Joseph into the opening scene. Yeah, in Galilee. I think that's the case. Okay, next is, yeah, Chris Martin and the Coldplay and Lilies in Viva La Vida pretending that he's a revolutionary. Yeah, and all his songs are about Jewish faith and the Christian faith and the festival of lights and everybody having to be dragged around the world. And he's got in the Fix You video the sun god Sol on the end of a massive rope and he spins it around his head and none of them see the pathologies coming. And his body doubles are very, very genial. They always smiled at me because this is the biggest fraud in world history. Yeah, and there he is in his ordinary civil gear. They were in Manchester making a fundraiser for Ariana, whatever her name was, the day after that false terror occurred. Yeah, it's the meaning of life for every one of the false news profiteers. Yeah, and there he is as Flavius Josephus's statue. Okay, so next image. So did you get the Ballon d'Or? Let me show you some of the winners of that. We'll have to go up. So the first one in Britain was a Blackpool player, Stanley Matthews. Okay, there he is.
There's Bobby Charlton. Ballon d'Or, which is the sun god, rooting it around all over the pitch. It's the same for every sports tournament in the world. Yeah, that's the role of the gods now. Yeah, and they think they're ever so clever. Yeah, even Bobby Charlton, my greatest hero, is still alive. I used to fish in the syndicate with his brother. He was the master's apprentice that killed every fish that he caught, regardless of their condition.
So let's just scan down and name some names as we see them. Okay. So there is the Christian.
Yeah, to get him. He's been injured for a long time. He's one of the Spanish teams. Ronaldo. Okay. And
Lionel Messi has won it 5 times. The Eastern Europeans, that is Puskas.
All of it is the same. Get the Emirates being in charge of all those football clubs since I revealed that Arsenal and Arsenal are on the Piso bloodline that takes you to Bush and Windsor.
And I think that will be on one of the tabs too. Okay.
What the hell is this? Oh, it's Prince Harry getting bitten by the Shetland pony. But that never shows up. They've banned it.
Yeah, because that is the Queen Victoria stories.
This site cannot be reached. But you can get pictures of Prince Harry's willy. Yeah? And I can show you them to you if you want to see them. Just approach me in the pub.
Okay, and there is the Ballon d'Or. And the definition of it. And the story on it. Okay, I think we should go to the other computer because those are now older tabs, but it all explains the football players. So Ruud Gullit,
yeah, and all of it, the gods give me the messages to look these up. Yeah, there is the Ballon d'Or with Michel Platini, yeah, the PL joke, the PL joke, pictured with the 1985 Ballon d'Or, won the award.
session. Okay? And you get it. So it's the same for snooker. Into the hole it goes. Yeah? That's the sun setting every evening. And there is Root Hoolet and all the Gulliver's travels. Yeah, all of them are religious motives, especially in Holland. Yeah, he's died too late, I think he has. Maybe not. Look it up if you like. And there is Larry Page. What the hell is he? This is early days of Google. I don't know what the religious story is for him, but here is the one of the surprising things. When you look up Muddy Jar, yeah, you can get volcanic eruptions by the gods, even in mud plains that are dried lakes. Yeah, and this is just the cover for the Muddy Jar murders. That's the architecture of their castles. So the launch of Carlos the Jackal was the killing of Marcus Manuel, yeah, by the British royals, and all of that happened in Cintra Abbey, which is built to the Muddy Jar design. And if you look at the earthquakes and the eruptions of the muddy volcanoes, it explains the song that Shakira sings. She's in the mug because she's married to another Barcelona player who's called Piqué, which is the Formula One family's. Sorry, I'm wasting time on the trivial stuff. And there is the stuff that it becomes, because the peseta, as soon as the European Union, the peso coinage was rejected, and that costs all the ordinary people a fortune. But all of the people that are in the 5,000 most rich families in the world, like Lionel Messi and Shimon Peres, get the benefit of every monetary stamp. You get the peso peseta. Yeah, and it was banned right up. It was the currency of Spain, 1869 to 2002. Sorry, I'm not sure how much time we've used already, but I need to skip through this. And there's the Lisbon, yeah, the Campo Bull Rings, yeah, and the massive, yeah, domes that they then put into the Christian countries to divide them. That is the launch of Moorism and the Moors coming into Spain. And it's a massive cause of death, but not nearly as big as the Christian Inquisitions, when the leaders were the kings and queens of Spain, and they killed millions of their own people, even the clerics in the Inquisitions. Yeah, and those are all the folk in the El Cid movie, and you get the irony of the one about the Statue of Liberty sticking up, built on sand. Yeah, the whole lot of it is a massive pistake, and I don't understand. Oh, there's the true authorship. So the reason that they sing the coat of many colours, Oprah introduces Dolly Parton. Let me show you that. Okay, let me explain the rules first. Okay, the Jewish Joseph of Genesis, 12 brothers. For Joseph in the Bible, it's 12 disciples. Spices on the camels, that's spices with the Magi and the three kings that become Churchill, Roosevelt and Stalin. They're the biggest killers. Joseph flees without his cloak from Potiphar's wife. The young disciple flees without his cloak when Jesus is arrested. Then, in Egypt, Joseph was sold for 20 pieces of silver. In the Christianity story, he was sold for 30. Brother Judah suggests the sale in Egypt. Yeah, that's the role played, Judah, by Charles. the Bible. Okay, so this is another version of the Bible in N.T. Piso Brown pamphlet. That's the papyri joke. Yeah, and this one does not have a mention that the true authorship for the Pisos also includes the Quran. Yeah, there's all the rules. Yeah, and there is the Gospel of Matthew
being produced by Arius Quirinius Piso, a.k.a. Josephus, from 70 to 75. Present Gospel of Mark, 75 to 80. Gospel of Luke, with the help of Pliny the Younger. Remember, Pliny the Elder died under Vesuvius because he was so arrogant that he thought he understood all of the nature's laws. Yeah, and that is Piggott Smith. Yeah, and Maggie Smith, and all of them are descended from the same lines.
I should have taken a picture of James Corden, because he gets away literally with murder and everything that they cover up the royal crimes with. So there is Jessius Horace.
Yeah, that is the pathetic woman. She is the son of that actor that was in The Vicar of Dibley, and he died really young in North London just a few weeks ago. All of them are friends of Bellboy, and that is Jessie in The River Runs Through the Lake. Yeah. He becomes the lover of the hero who's a university professor, and all of them, she's a sex maniac in Brighton and the other students. I forget what her name was, but we might find that under here if we have a look.
Oh no. Oh. Sorry, I'm going to have to.
All the tabs on that computer.
Sorry, I just need to put my password in this other one.
Nothing has been recently closed.
Jesse character. But they've shut down the page that I got the whole story from this morning. And they're pretending that there's nothing there. Pro-Jewish, the Jewish war, main article. No, this is not it. That's End Times Study. And I can't go back from there. And it's telling me that I've not shut any pages down. But it could be on the other tab though. No? The river runs through it with Brad Pitt and all those people and the Christian vicar that is in it. I now understand every character in almost every movie that's been made. So Emily Lloyd's father is Roger Lloyd Pack. He's deceased because he's a pistachio too. Part of that vicar Dibley joke. Do you get it? All of them think that they are immune from the acts of God. Until the Star Wars team start quake. Okay, and this young gets her kit off all the time in all the movies she makes. So I cannot now. What they've done is they've shut down the massively surprising Flavius Joseph statue. Let's see that. Ah, there it is. See the picture that led me. Flavius Joseph's statue, and there's Pismar. Okay, there is Arius Copernicus Pisa, and those are them with now with the beekeeper's hat on for the busy bees that are mentioned. So I think everything will be okay, because that there's oh no. So it was called Livius, there it is. Okay? This is the way in to telling you the shocking news about how the whole of religion is false. Okay? Chris Martin again called Flavius Josephus, but this is not the same website. Yeah, 20 volumes of the Jewish Antiquities in which Flavius Josephus explains Jewish history. Yeah, its model is a book by Greek historian Dionysius of Halicarnassus, who wrote 20 books of Roman antiquities. And it's got Jennifer Aniston and all the things I've been preparing all morning. But that is not the same one. In fact, doesn't it inform means that he thought that Jesus was innocent. Yeah, they have an amazing way of obfuscating the truth. Okay, Josephus is Jewish Antiquities. So let's just go back and see if we can find, and they won't let us go back now, have you noticed that? Click to go back, and we've not closed any websites. And there's another one of the options that were on that page. Statue 1. Hit. Sorry. So there's the massive scenes where they look at the statue, but that is not letting me get to through that story I found on that web page this morning. Josephus End Time Study. So that is not the one. It was all written by the same Angel Fire and Arius and Abelard Reuchlin. Ever so closely. So let's have another go at just looking for, open a new tab and just open statue of Josephus. Flavius Josephus. Is how I started when I got up this morning as instructed. Josephus Wikipedia, statue, Josephus Flavius, Jewish Encyclopedia, so we've got that one open. And there is the Jewish Antiquities and Livius. Not the same scholarly source that I was looking at this morning, with all those massive links and further references beyond them, that's been taken down. Started on this computer, and they're pretending that none of the sites has actually been closed. Flavius Josephus, oh, that. Okay, this is it. Pen name of Arius Piso, Flavius Josephus. Okay, are you trained on it? And let me see if I can find Jesse. And all the jokes, so Aniston is off through it. Abelard Reuchlin, and his true identity is decipherable only by reconstruction. Caesanius Paetus, I think I need to read the first paragraph or two, and otherwise it will not make sense. Okay, but this is the page. Roman Piso, homepage, bookshelf. Flavius Josephus was really Arius Piso. The tie-in is that Arius the Elder was married to the Emperor Vespasian's brother before Vespasian became Emperor. He was T. Flavius Sabinus. For Abelard Reuchlin, that is the opening statements that he makes on the bloodline for the Piso family, and he's just got it on a chalkboard, and he is frequently cited in this story. Okay, from this relationship we find the connection to the alias names of Pisos as Paetus, that is Paterculus, and everything that we've told you about, that's spelled P-A-E, Tus, quoting from the true authorship of the New Testament. Vespasian relied upon Piso because he was grandson of his own brother. Yeah? And you can hear the wind howling. Vespasian's brother, T. Flavius Sabinus, had married Diapetus of Piso's father, L. Calpurnius Piso. We now know Irius Piso's father to have been Gaius Calpurnius Piso, who was executed by Nero. See page 20, supra, wherein Piso himself is also mentioned. And as Socinus Paetus, so he just keeps on inventing the biblical characters, and he keeps on giving himself new titles. Okay, the son of Thrasius Paetus Gaius Calpurnius Piso, and then so Flavius Josephus, and then we get Montanus as another alias name of Irius Piso. You get the Montague families now. Mountains from a molehill. Yeah, and that is Montanus. Yeah, and the woman that was that Jessie woman in that family that died young, she only swears and gives anatomical predictions and talks about words like cunt. And she jumps in bed with everything that she can make sex with. And all of it is the same joke. You'll see her further down. Okay, there are elements of this that are given in the true authorship of the New Testament that may or not be necessary to repeat here. In detail, you see how it is that Thrasia Paetus and Aria are seen as actually being Gaius Piso and his wife. That's the parents. Let me see if I can find Jennifer Aniston. Her real name is Flavia, and here's the Fanias. Yeah, okay. Her real name was used to make her alias name. She was Flavia Aria. Yeah, the feminine form of Flavius, and the name of her mother and grandmother, Aria. You get the Ariana Huffingtons and the Arian Victor of the Terror in Manchester. Yeah, all of it is the same families. They used the F in Flavia as an initial and left it in front of her Aria name. Change the R's in her name to N's, which is explained by this. One new language in inverted commas, this rendered the alias name of Fania. Yeah, isn't that funny? The American Fania. Who wrote the book of love? Are you getting it now? Her brother likewise, also already carried, used the Flavius name, and he would have the masculine form of his mother name, and therefore would be Arius. And now we have the Arius portion of his name, but we also find a bit more, much more confirmation of this as we research and deduce further. Down we go. Likewise, Montanus, the mountain, is spared out of consideration, his father having died because of Nero. And all of it refers to Tacitus, and that's another name for Arius's team. Yeah? See the letters of Pliny the Younger, Letters and Panegyricus, Loeb Classic Library. Flavius Josephus was a pen name of Arius. Chris Martin's bloodline, yet the money man on the meat. Some of the items from above may be repeated here. Let's find Aniston. She's lovely, and every one of the movies she makes, watch the movie clips, and you will see how obscene the whole of this story is. Yeah, because all of it is just a joke, really, and it is the Christian Bible that everybody swears on to get married, Valerie Jane Lees. Okay, and so remember, this name was deliberately hidden and for an express purpose. So let's start that one again. To restate this, the name of Arius Calpurnius Piso is not found outright in ancient history, but it can be deduced and therefore reconstructed because it is found in parts or chopped up here and there. It is a matter of putting all of the parts together to get this true full watch the movie trailer and put the word Miller in it, and you'll see how, with all our kit off and all the swear words and everything that is in this family bloodline. She's a very attractive woman, but the gods do not like me to get diverted into the world's most evil bloodlines.
It's happening already.
Okay, Flavius Josephus, being the primary author of the Gospels and the inventor of Jesus, is simply the correlation that are found between the works of Flavius Josephus and the New Testament itself. I'm going to go down until I see Jennifer. And it's bibliotechapplyaids.net sociopolitica /esp-sociopol-piso07html. Father of Jesus, that he was also a ruler. Kings were sometimes called governors. As Sosenius Paetus, governor of Syria. Yeah. Wisdom translation, also the true authorship by there's Emperor Domitio. Or here's Archippus. Okay, here it is. As Claudius Ariston, he was called the leading citizen of Ephesus, reference to Pliny, what the younger of the elder. The younger was married to the grandson of his man. Ephesus was the chief city of the Roman province of Asia, which was to the southwest of Bithynia. He also, and that's why the Bitcoins are in the news all the time, they're on these websites. Yet we also find him as Flavius Archippus, who was supposedly a philosopher in the Emperor Domitian, commended Pliny the Younger. His author name identity of Lapius Maximus, that is John Lapp in the movie of the Amish. See true authorship of the New Testament right through the whole of world history. The emperor ordered Pliny to buy him a farm near Prusa in Bithynia, and out of public funds, it would appear, or else by ruthless means, to obtain this farm property, the people of Prusa, where do you get? Prussia now, and the place where I had to get my permission to leave England, which was Prada in on the English border, voted to put up a statue as a tribute to him, Flavius Archippus, aka Josephus. Yeah, and the gods hate it. And I think you can refer to that. And important items to note, the Pantera riddle. Yeah, so look at Jennifer Aniston's pants and her capacity to talk about her fanny, and all of her friends' capacities to talk about the penis, which is the fish. Okay, the correlations between the works of Flavius Josephus and the New Testament. Jesus and Piso are both famous in Syria, where we are now committing genocide by carpet bombing again, because all of them, Assad, all of it, is the English-speaking syndicate. The word denarius, used in Revelations, ask a question to deny that Jesus ever lived as the author. Alias names can be used to build profiles of the actual persons. Arius Piso's descent from Mark Antony and Cleopatra, and eventually down to Queen Elizabeth II, George W. Bush, and Delaney's donkey, Roosevelt family, and that is Jesus in the Bible. They're ever so clever. And the word Nini and Dragon mean baby boy, which is Jesus. You get the Ken Dodd and the Diddy Men and all the Ninis that are the El Nino, which is now the weather part of the skies, and that is just the baby Jesus mother. Yeah, and that is the eco crimes of Bill Clinton and the whole of the global warming profiteers, and it will be a his alias names. Okay, there's a list of them. Sisonius Pizel, Paetus, Arius Coponius. Arius Coponius Pizel, his real name, leads us to Montanus, Montague, the Dukes of Buccleuch, Sarah Montague, and all of the Colin Montgomery lookalikes for the Roman busts. Montanus leads us to Arius Antoninus. Arius Antoninus leads us to Arius Verus, which is the name of the now dead father of the boy in the Gladiator movie. Arius Verus leads us to Annius Gallus. Annius Gallus leads us to Cestius Gallus. Cestius Gallus leads us to Jessius Florus. Look up Jesse. Yeah, and that name that I just told you, the dead father, Jessius Florus, leads us to Antoninus Primus. Antoninus Primus. So all of them are the same person. Right, I'm now going to try and find something that actually is. When I found it the other day. So all of these are actually the Roman emperor, and they become the papal bloodlines as soon as they realise that God can explode the volcano next to the family home. Yeah, the Villa Papyri in Naples that was buried under the planets of lava. Okay. So there's whole lists of panteras, that is Shania Twain's sins, in the panther uniforms and in the leopard skin uniforms. She's playing goddesses out of Egypt and out of the Isis myths, and it is really dangerous to do that, Shania, and I've worshipped you for all of my days. And I still love your music. The Greek word panthera for mother is in Mark 1:30, Matt 8:14. But let me now try and find on my other computer the stuff that is so shocking about Arius Coponius Piso actually being St. Peter. Yeah, that is St. Peter, that is the first bishop of Rome. And when I saw it last week, I could not believe it. Yeah, and the weather storms have been occurring ever since I discovered it. So I just hope we can find it. If I go to the end of religion. Yeah, it is endless. Take my word for it. I hope the gods will end it soon, and that we can all start worshipping them for their greatness. Bear with me. Let me see what the title of that document is so you can all look it up and find it. Okay? It's the Roman Piso homepage bookshelf website. Jennifer Aniston, please mend your ways. Right then.
As soon as you discover that you have
an explosive mountain, which is the button press for the gods. Yeah, I believe that there are gods all around the world, and there are many of them. Yeah, this is Calpurnius Piso family and the origin of popes. Yeah, so he faked Jesus. His grandson was murdered because he faked the devil, and he put the devil into the Bible. Yeah, on the 66th chapter, which is Revelations, and the name of my website, his father, grandfather, was the devil in that last chapter. Yeah, and they then murdered that youngster. Okay, the Calpurnius Piso family and the origin of popes. Background and summary. And if you go down, you'll find not only Chris Higgins, the professor that refused me a job's bloodline, you will find all sorts of interesting Piso. One was Bruno Baer, another was James Valentine Haney. Yeah, their works, and read them. These are the analysts, that's the Haneys that got on the clock face again. That's the Valentines that are the millionaires and the owners of the Cross Keys Hotel for the Vatican in Kelso. And the Baers, you've heard about in a Rothschild context. Okay, Reuchlin and all of it. Yeah, let's get down to the list of the names and what they were when they became the popes. True identities, yet none of... Abelard Reuchlin was the first person to write publicly about Flavius Josephus, a.k.a. Arius Calpurnius Piso. He is the one through his work had discovered that Arius Piso was, a.k.a. St. Peter, the first bishop of Rome, later to be known as popes. Yeah, and they're in Rome now because it's safer and there is no volcano. And the Bushes are now in a house called Vesuvius on the Azure Main, yet the main county in America, and that is why they are on the bloodline as the George Herbert Popea Bush. You get it? St. Peter equals Arius Calpurnius Piso, born 37